A week ago, I visited with Chrysostom and Karen when they were getting ready for the wedding, and as I left, I saw them holding hands and joyfully carrying two giant trash bags to the dumpster. And I thought to myself, they're ready.
We've argued that we can look at each other and kind of just know what the other one is feeling and thinking. And I can tell you when Chrysostom came into her life, I was so relieved and joyful because I knew this was the perfect match. And I've been just overwhelmed with joy seeing you two. You guys are such a wonderful example of godly love, and they're going to be the godparents to our baby, Anthony, and I can't think of anyone better. And my sweet husband, Stephen, said a quote recently. He said, marriage is like a dance. You're liable to step on each other's toes, which, so to always pray together and just, you know, at nights when things are hard and we're tired, just holding hands and praying together will really change so many things that seem insurmountable. And I love you so much, both of you. And I just thrilled and love you. Cheers to Karen and Chrysostom.
Today we celebrate an important spiritual event in your lives and in the life of this community. The marriage of Chrysostom, whom so many of you know as Lance, and Katherine, many of you, the rest of you know as Karen. Because the way their parents raised them, because the education they pursue, and due to the way they have developed the talents that they have, when they met here, something very awesome happened.
Thank you. is betrothed the handmaid of God, Catherine, of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The handmaid of God, Catherine, is betrothed the servant of God, Lamb, Chrysostom, name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Somehow you're the girl standing here in front of me tonight.
The bride, the groom, Mr. and Mrs. Arthur. And always keep heaven before you. The best way to grow towards each other is to grow towards Christ. If you remember that marriage has been given to you for your salvation, all the sorrows and joys of life will be put in the right perspective. Humbling yourself before your spouse, being patient, and being forgiving will be so much easier if you remember that the kingdom of God is the goal.
I choose you. Of my